First of all, I really would like to say there is no such thing as a too confrontational question or a stupid question, seriously. If there aren't any confrontational questions, it gets boring. I mean, for everybody, including us. So ask anything you want. If we don't want to answer, we'll lie.
Okay? And if she says, now that's a very good question, which means, whoops, you're going to stall a little bit.
Right.
Okay.
Okay, yeah.
Do you start with questions? Or
no,
or
no,
you
start.
Oh.
Are our mics set up and you can hear these guys, right, in the back? You can't hear me. Okay, well, maybe they'll turn. Let's get your question. So how is the book on cacti coming along, and can somebody really see you at Bohemian Grove? Oh.
The book on cactus is coming along quite well. About every month or two, I'm asked how's it going along, and I answer it will be done in a couple of months. And that's been going on for about a year now. I hope it'll be done in a couple of months. We've decided not to add any more compounds. Just go right ahead. And as it stands now, it's about 2,000 compounds, phenethylamines primarily. Phenethylamines are known to be psychedelic, those that are suspected of being but have not been found to be, and those which have not been tried. And it currently is running about 2,000 pages. And we call it the psychedelic index, or the maybe the phenethylamine index, in imitation of the Merck index. same thing. But every comment in there is documented, and it's, I think it'd be a nice reference book for the nice people who are the drug synthetic chemists, and the other people such as DEA and such. The information's all there, it's all documented, it's gonna be very useful. Now, what's about the Bohemian Grove? Sorry. What about the Bohemian Grove?
Were you actually seen at Bohemian Grove?
I was up there this year again, yes. Bohemian Grove's kind of a neat little retreat up in the Russian River area. And during the weekends, it's maybe 2,000 or 3,000 people. But during the week, there are only about 200 or 300 people. It's a delightful place, no radios, no television, just quietly sit over there. And you can start the whole day with a beautiful Bloody Mary and end up with a little red wine, which is a delightful way of spending 2 weeks.
He's actually been a member of the club for, what, 40 years?
Oh, almost 1 year short of 50 years now.
Okay, yeah. It's not just Republican conservatives.
Oh, no, 85% Republican conservatives. It's a very ex-president, Republican presidents, of course. And no president while he's in office has ever been at the Grove, because no president in office is ever off the record. And everything in the Grove is off the record. And so it's a very nice, nice place to see ex-presidents. My first ex-president I ever met there was a fellow named Herbert Hoover. This is some probably before many of your time. But he was a very nice person. He had retired from the presidency. And he gave a lakeside talk, the way I met him was this lakeside talk, where you go down to the lake and you give a talk for 25 minutes. And the name of the talk was the something to do with
politics, or the politics of fly fishing. I've been married to him for 27 years, so I've heard all these over and over again.
What's the politics of
fly fishing?
Of fishing. The politics of fishing. He loved fishing. And he was an ex-president, so I thought the politics of fishing would be using fishing as an analog for political goings-on. And no, he used the political goings-on as an analog of how you catch fish. Delightful talk. Totally unexpected. A very interesting person. He died next year. More questions.
Another question. Sir.
Thank you.
In chocolate?
I'll take the second question.
Let me repeat the question. There's an auditory hallucinogen called Sinoquichi, and he wondered if that was in any way related to the substance I had mentioned before, and then we'll do the second question.
I love the term Sinoquichi. It has a nice bite to it, you know, Sinoquichi. No, I frankly, as to the question about chocolate, I don't have the foggiest idea why it's a compulsion. I love eating it, but I didn't realize there's a nice addictive drug in it. Now I'm going to look at it more closely.
Is it theobromine? Theobromine. Is that
theobromine? Yeah.
Yeah. That's in chocolate.
I guess it is.
Is it a turn on? Mm-hmm.
But I don't remember it being addictive.
I don't think so either.
chocolate ice cream that you can take.
Yeah. Right. the name you mentioned is a drug with effects on the auditory system. I don't know what that's chemically. Sasha discovered one called DIPT, whose only effects are changing the way music sounds. Everything is out of kilter.
Distorting the sound of music.
A severe distortion of music. But this other one, that's a new name. What country does it come from? Really?
No, new to me. Don't know anything about it.
That's something for us to look up. Yeah.
Another question. Alan. Did Sasha help with the transformation of Attorney General Mitchell at Bohemian Grove?
Well, I have made a couple of little plays of playing the role of a waiter at the club. It's a very nice way of meeting people who don't know you, and you can make all kinds of wise-ass comments, and they are offended by the fact you're employed here and making these nasty comments. But then someone tips them off that you've actually been a member for 50 years. You're getting away with it. You know, actually, the Bohemian Grove is a very delightful. The whole Bohemian Club is known primarily as a bunch of ex-important people, Republicans, of course. But there's a small percentage, about maybe 20%, who are in there, as I have been for lots of years, because I play the viola. So I'm in the orchestra. And the orchestra, they don't have any waiting time to come in. Normally it's a 10-year wait to become a member, and something like a $25,000 membership fee or something horrible. But when you come in as a musician, you come in for a year of trial, and you play in your orchestra for a while. And if they like the way you play, and you like them, and you can fit along with a crowd, and you spent a year and you haven't really made any trouble, then you're in as a member, and it doesn't cost you a penny. Just very, very delightful way out.
Despite all the mythology about Bohemian Club, it's mostly about music.
Yeah.
Actually, that's what goes on most
music
of the time.
Music and art and play.
Yeah, it's okay.
Shows, writing shows, designing costumes,
right.
That kind of thing.
Okay, next question.
Oh, next question.
Okay, another question. Gentlemen, way in the back. Thank you.